And welcome back, everybody, to another cooking tutorial. We're gonna cook some emu today. Here's Larry, Curly, and Mo having their dinner. Mom and I went to the Indian grocery store and we picked up some interesting things. Sometimes you get a little tired of eating the same things, and so we're gonna mix it up a little bit today. So we picked up this red curry sauce. It's just a simmer sauce. And there's very little you need to put along with this besides water and maybe some vegetables if you want to. It calls for 12 ounces of chicken or any other protein. So we're going to use some emu. Here's the ingredients. I did not react to this. However, if you have food allergies or alpha gal like I do, doesn't necessarily, because I don't react to it, doesn't mean you may not react to it. I'm not sure about the sugar, for instance. So please make sure that you keep your family safe. Here's our flat filet. It is half a pound each. I've got two of them in here. I figure after I've turned them all up and got all the fat and silver skin off of here, it should probably have about probably a little more than 12 ounces, but that's okay. So you notice quite a bit of silver skin on here and some sinew. We're going to need to get all of that off. These are four different muscles. Your emu cuts are just individual muscles, so they're going to have silver skin and connective tissue on every single one of these pieces. There's my trusty good knife. I want a nice good fillet knife. This is a, I think they were selling it at Walmart as a fish filleting knife, but it's good. It's got a nice pointy tip. Nice and sharp, gets underneath there and cut all that off. Really honestly, it looks like there's a lot. There's just long pieces of it that you've got to get off. Here you can see the real silver skin on this one. And this good knife gets it right up underneath there and pulls right off. So these flat fillets are probably pretty good for barbecuing. I would marinate them maybe and put them on the grill and then cut them in lengthwise, and they would make some really great fajitas. And when you cut them lengthwise, honestly, you're really not going to notice some of that sinew because you're going to cut it in thin, small pieces anyways. But because of slightly bigger pieces that I'm going to cut for this curry, I want to make sure that I get most of this out. And we're going to have a little pile of emu trimmings, and I'll go over to my mom and dad's house later on, and the puppy will be very happy to see me because he knows that Aunt Amy always has some little treat for him. And that'll be gone in 2 seconds. Absolutely no waste whatsoever. See, four pieces. And yeah, I'm gonna get that big piece of sinew off of there. You'll be happy you did that. Look, it just pulls right off. And then you've got that piece, and you've got that some connective tissue that kind of runs down through the middle. I'm just checking out what else we've got here. There. Now, these fillets, see the meat fibers run along the length. And so you're going to want to cut them on the short end there. Oh, look at that. Look how tough this is. Yeah, this that is not going to cook out, folks. You got to get this off. And it's if you don't get it off, your meat's going to be extremely tough and you're not going to be happy and you're going to say, "My emu's so tough. Why is it so tough?" Well, you got to take the time to do this. All right. And just one more. Look at it, just pulls right out of there. Look at that. One lung piece. Dog doesn't care. He'll just inhale it. And you can scrape some of the meat off of it if you want to. Doesn't matter, it's all going in the simmer sauce. It's all going over rice or cauliflower rice or naan bread or whatever you want to use. See, there's some connecting tissue in here. I'm just going to pull this apart. Look at this. Just pull it right apart and then cut it out. Then I'm cutting less, right, against the meat fibers. Can make some chunks. There's our pile of emu meat ready to go in. All right. So, real simple sauce, just the sauce. I'm going to add a 3/4 cup of water because I think the emu is going to take a little longer to cook than the chicken would. 12 ounces. We have a little more than 12 ounces, but that's okay. Pineapple. I have got a can of pineapple. Let's put some pineapple in it. Absolutely. So I got a can of pineapple. Let's strain it out. And we'll put the pineapple juice in the simmer sauce, and then we'll add some of that pineapple back in, and then yeah, why do the extra pineapple? Put it in a cake. What else? Won't go to waste. All right. So here's our simmer sauce, and I put 3/4 of a cup of water because I do think that the emu is going to cook a little, take a little longer to cook, plus the pineapple juice. I can't leave any recipe along, honestly. Notice it's got whole kaffir lime leaves in there. I'll point those out to you a little later on. This is going to cook down a little bit. I want to get this heated up, kind of to a simmer. And after that, then we'll put in our meat. There it is. It's simmering. Looks good. Let's turn down the temperature. And we'll add our emu. Beautiful lean emu. And we'll add a little bit of pineapple in there. Not all that. Maybe half a cup. Whatever you like. You could put some vegetables in here too. You could put some green peppers, some green onions, tomatoes if you like. It's just a simmer sauce. Whatever you like. Whatever makes you happy. So get that up to a boil again, and then we'll turn it down to a simmer and let it cook until everything's, take a piece out, see if it's tender. I think mine cooked about 35 minutes. And there it is. Don't forget to take out that little kaffir lime leaf in there. That's that little green thing in there. It's very chewy. Sorry I didn't plate it up for you, but thanks so much for watching, and you have a great afternoon.